first camera. We in Best Buy.
Yay!
Oh, I'm gonna die.
Say hi, Zoe.
Hold it.
There you go. Hold it right there.
Hold it right here.
Yeah.
We vlogging. We
Daddy,
huh? My baby trying to take my shine already, man. Why you trying to take my shine? Don't take my shine. Come on, man.
Daddy, let me hold it.
Why you want to hold it?
Let me hold it. Hey, Daddy. Ivy, look. Ivy, look.
Hi.
Now we out here vlogging.
No.
Can't let us film.
No.
We out here.
No.
You want the camera? You want to fight over the vlog already?
Yeah.
Golly! What's the deal, man? I'm T-Real, you feel me? I know y'all already know me. And if you don't know me, boy, you better click that MTV show, you feel me? Because I was on there, you know what I'm saying? I was on Lil Wayne's tour, I was on there. I was on Drake's tour, I was on there. Puff Daddy tour, I was like, I was performing, you know what I'm saying?
So, I'm Heather Sanders, and you may know me from Instagram, because I'm popping on there. But yeah, you probably know me from Instagram. I own my own business. It's called Sorella Boutique. We're online and on Melrose, so you probably know me from there. You might catch me on the block. I'm from Dallas, Texas. Originally from Dallas, Texas. I moved to California 7 years ago.
I'm from Los Angeles, California, the ghetto. You feel me? I'm one of them statistics that don't, you know, never grew up with his pops. I think he was there for about 2-3 years. Maybe I give or take, whatever.
I have 3 sisters. My mom and dad.
Moms is there. Moms is moms and my pops. Shout out to Denise Mix, man. You know what I'm saying? I love you.
I have a new baby, Zoe. And I have a baby on the way, Supreme.
I got 3 kids. You old. You stupid. I can't even get nobody. How you gonna go get another girl, you know what I'm saying? You gonna introduce yourself? Yeah, what's up, man? I'm T-Rell. I got 3 kids. She ain't even gonna mess with me no more. Man, I love my kids. I'm really sensitive about my kids. And I'm really sensitive about being a good dad.
So this YouTube thing is kind of new for me. I never really open up. I never really even speak. So I'm excited to hop on this YouTube journey, and I'm excited for you guys to get to know me a little bit more, get to meet my family, and follow me on this pregnancy journey and a new family adventure. And yeah, I'm excited.
You too, here we come.
If you want to really learn about me, you want to really see me, you want to really see how I interact with my people, my family, and see what I got going on, you know what I'm saying? Better subscribe, better like, better comment, all the little YouTube stuff, however they be doing. I'm new to this, but you know what I'm saying, I'm gonna get used to it. So if you guys really wanna see me, check us out.
So now we're gonna answer a couple of the questions from our fans. We first met on Twitter, and he slid in my DMs on Twitter, and he's like, I'm gonna come to Texas. I'm like, okay, Texas is huge. Well, where are you going? He's like, El Paso. I'm like, well, I'm not in El Paso. So when you get to Dallas, hit me. Then he hit me when he gets to Dallas. Like, I'm coming to Dallas. And then by that time, it was like already 2 months have gone by. So we were like already on the phone. And
so I was on mute.
Yeah. But I was thirsty. And I followed like everybody like that it was like affiliated with Young Money. So I found him out of, I don't know, and I followed him, and then he slid in my DMs.
First off, I was just on the random, which is correct. I did split in your DMs because I was on the random, like, let me see who all following me, because I was getting a lot of followers around that time. I'm like, damn, she looked cool.
She was the little ass model. She had her ass out in the air or whatever. I'm like, damn, I ain't really had no girl with the ass out in the air. You feel me? And around that time, media takeout was popping. You had a media takeout with me, like, the next hot model. Like, it was not the next hot model, but you was cool. Yeah, you know you did. Come on. When you was thirsty. But I did slide your DMs. I'm like, yo, we coming to Texas, come through. You know what I'm saying? I didn't already know that she probably knew half the niggas on the bus already. I didn't know that. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, I'm thinking it's something new, come to Texas. She already knew what we was doing. You thirsty, homie, now that I think about it. Damn, I was actually embarrassed.
They're my friends.
I'm like, yo, look, I got this new girl named Heaven. They like, stupid
point.
Y'all
know
Heaven.
No, but they all knew me. Okay, so that's how we met.
Being thirsty.
On Twitter. Slid in my DMs. And we met in 2010.
That was about 2 months. We were just having phone conversation. You know what I'm saying? I just fell in love with you over the phone before I even met you. Could have been catfishing. You could have been huge. I was looking here from here. Could have been 500 pounds.
Okay.
With a pretty face.
We first linked up after a show, but I didn't see him at the actual show. It was a Lil Wayne show, and then I went to the hotel afterwards to hang out with him.
Damn, she thirsty. Yeah. Don't mind her in my chip. She's gonna be pregnant. You know what I'm saying? It's all good. You get the pass, because if she wasn't, I'd be hot. She came to the hotel. And I'm looking, she was walking up, it was a movie. I'm like, damn, I'm finna really be with this girl.
Aww, you did?
I'm finna really be with this girl.
Why?
I don't know, huh? It might have been God or something. It was some light shining in all me. Shit in my ear, the world stopped. I'm like, man, this is crazy. So I had to get a confirmation.
Oh, Terrell.
I had to get a confirmation. So I took you up to the room, not to hit, but to get a confirmation from the homie. So you sat down and me and the homie just looking at you. And then that was all she wrote.
And when he first met me, this is the first thing he did when we first came in contact with each other. He put me in a headlock like this and said, let me fuck. Like, what?
I was just joking, though. You
yeah,
know?
He was,
I was
joking.
Just joking. I was just joking or whatever.
But we had already knew each other because we were, like, talking on the phone for, like, 2 months. So it was comfortable.
Yeah.
We were going back and forth for, like, a year. Well, not even a year. Probably, like, a couple months. Like, 4 or 5 months. I was flying to L.A. He was flying to Texas. And we liked each other. So I was like, I need to be your girlfriend. And everybody needs to know that I'm your girlfriend. Like, all these little girls need to know that I'm your girl. And then our friend...
Because it was crazy. I had... Let that be known. It was crazy.
His friend Brittany was like, Terrell, you need to make her your girlfriend. She's a good girl. And then he just called me one day and he was like, you want to be my girlfriend?
I didn't ask her. That's corny. I didn't even ask her like that, man. She crazy, man.
Yes, he did. I'm like, yeah,
that shit sound crazy. That's what I did do. But look, we was going back and forth or whatever, and that one last time you had to go back to LAX, it just didn't feel right. I'm like, nah, this the last time, bruh.
Yeah, I was crying at the car. I was like, I do not want to go back to Texas. Like, I can't go back to Texas. I cannot do this anymore. Like, I don't want to do it anymore. He's like, this is the last time that you're gonna have to ever go back to Texas. I'm like, okay. And then after that, I moved out here.
She thought I had bread.
I knew he didn't have no money.
You know what? No, you thought I had some bread. I had no money. I'm like, this is the last time you gonna ever have to do anything. Like, nigga, if I had a little bit of bread, but you was trusting it. You know what I'm saying? I was trusting. I already had put my faith in it. I already knew what was gonna happen. You know what I'm saying?
So we decided to move. I decided to move from Dallas, Fort Worth, to Los Angeles, California.
Gotta get the last bit.
He flew from LA to my house. We packed up my car. My family was like, you're crazy.
First
Where
off,
are you going?
You needed a car.
I needed a car. Bread. He gave me like $7,000 to put down on my car or something. And I had like $3,000 and he gave me the rest to put down on my Ford Fusion.
That was my last little money.
I'm like, oh my gosh, he really gave me money for a car. I got my car.
Do you call that tricking?
Yeah. He been tricking, okay? We drove 26 hours from Dallas to Los Angeles, California. I drove. He didn't drive till we got to California.
We're really driving. Nice. We have all my stuff.
LA, Hollywood, the dreams come true.
Whatever. Okay.
163 miles till El Paso. And I have been driving this whole effing time. Terrell has not driven at all. But he's drinking a 5-hour energy about to drive. Look at those mountains. All those hours by myself while he was asleep.
I wasn't asleep. It was just like I was supporting you.
I'm helping you. I'm trying to stay up with you.
He's such a bitch.
She made the move. I came to her house. I threw away 90% of her clothes.
He's like, you're not taking all of this.
Because first of all, let's just get this straight. She was not fly. She was not fly at all. You know what I'm saying? From head to toe. We fixed it though. We fixed it. She caught on. She surpassed me 26 hours straight, and we've been here ever since.
Well, when I got to LA,
she had zero goals. It was just to be with me.
Yeah, I did.
At that moment, at that time, you know what I'm saying? We both came to our senses like we need to do something on our own to be independent.
Yeah.
And that something just happened to be fashion. If you look at our early on stuff, we were selling t-shirts. I mean, I ain't gonna direct y'all to the link, you just gonna have to find it. We were selling t-shirts, me and her, we was hustling.
But it took us a pretty long time to figure out exactly what I was gonna do. I was like, nobody has like a store that sells everybody's clothing line and everybody's stuff. I'm like, what is that called? And we Googled it and it's like, it's a boutique. I'm like, oh, I wanna start a boutique. That's what I can do. I can start a boutique and I can carry this and I can carry that and I can have whatever. I can make clothes, I can do this. And then ever since then we Googled like how to start your own online boutique. Nothing came up. So we literally had to like go out in the field, figure it out, self-taught, and we just went for it. And then I met Brittany, and my friend Brittany was doing like custom jeans. She hit me like, can I make you some custom shorts? And I met her in person. I was like, I can use her shorts and her jeans and all this stuff to make my boutique unique. And then Terrell was like, move her in. He is just crazy. He's like, move her in. She has to be here. Else you're not going to get your orders out on time.
We didn't know what we was about to do. We had to figure out a name of the company or whatever. Because we already had a name of my company. We really had to get the feel. So we got in the field. We did what we had to do in the field. She needed to get her stuff off the ground because she wanted to be independent too. So as a real one, I slipped her some bread. I'm like, let me give her some bread too. And then we're going to work on her thing and I'm going to work on my thing. You know what I'm saying? Eventually she started booming. Sorella Boutique started on the flow. You know what I'm saying? This is their warehouse. Literally, you know what I'm saying? So
Sorella means beautiful sister in Italian. And
it means sister. She just put the beautiful on there to make y'all.
To make it a little. And then we have Girls Tour too, which is a brand within Sorella. And it just means women empowerment, independent women, strong women, working women, and just representing for women and girls. Because nobody does.
Gordon, this is a big, big question. And I really, 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 really love her because the way she accepts me and loves me for me still unconditionally. She just been there with me from whatever, from the ground up. She accepted me for what I have got, you know, what I got going on. Rather it's my attitudes, you know what I'm saying?
He's crazy as hell.
you know, mood swings. I am a Gemini, you know what I'm saying? And so how can I really ever turn my back on that, you know what I'm saying? Like, shit, bad one.
And then why I really love Terrell, because he accepted me too, with all my flaws, and my past ain't pretty at all. So, and just believing in me and like seeing a person that I didn't even know that I could be. I'm gonna cry. Seeing a person that I didn't even know I could be and like helping me bring that person out. That's it. I'm going to cry.
That's because she's pregnant. She's full of shit.
I hate him too, though. And he's funny. And he makes me laugh. Even though he's so crazy, too. And we fight all the time. But, yeah.
And fights is like them Instagram. That shit really real.
So you going to sit here and you going to eat that shit when I ain't ate. When I ain't ate. You got me fucked up.
Oh my gosh, I cannot answer this one. We cannot answer this. What is your biggest pet peeve about each other?
Hair and toothpaste in the sink. It's like, I might pack my bags and leave right now, man. I'm tired of you. If I see that shit one more time, man. That's
just, yeah, but now, disgusting. 7 years later, I know, like, if I drop toothpaste in the sink to wash it out really fast with the water before I do anything else, because he'll go
what
crazy.
What was you doing before you married? What if you never?
I'm leaving it in the seat.
That's disgusting, homie.
And I can't go pee without the door shut. If he hears me pee, he said he'll break up with me.
Oh my goodness. Do you want to hear somebody peeing? Like, ooh, that's disgusting, bruh.
He's difficult as hell.
How do you pee and then try to hop back in the bed sexy?
It's light.
That's what I'm not doing. So you finna pee right now? You trying to hop back in the bed with me? You stupid.
My biggest pet peeve about him, he talks to you like you're stupid sometimes. And then another one is when we're at the store and we're at like Target and we spend like $400. The lady's like, okay, you told us $400. And he's like, that's it? Like, Tara, we're at Target spending $400. You know that we wrong. So why are you acting like it's nothing and you're just big balling? It just irks me. Like, that's it? Like, we just got all the money in the world to spend at Target.
It's really being sarcastic. You said, that's it. Like, it's really me.
That's it.
It's another form of me being sarcastic and saying, that shit's too damn high.
That's not, no.
I tried to play that one a little differently to make no sense. But cool. We have 3 kids. One on the way. Which is my boy Supreme, man, and man. That's why his name Supreme, because he's been the reign supreme. It ain't because of no clothes, man. Just, you know what I'm saying? So y'all can know. And then we have Zoe, who is a monster.
And tell my wife, hate to mean forever, ever, more than ever, mind. Oh, I smile with my little light.
Okay. She's crazy. Like, I don't even know. About time she
that's
get about,
my little baby. That's my first baby.
About time
with
she
him.
Get 10, it's gonna be crazy. She probably somebody. I ain't even wild with it, man. She got on first slippers.
Baby. Show me your slippers. She loves slippers. That's how she says it.
Hey.
Say hi, Zoe.
Then we have Ty Lee. She just turned 9. She's very intelligent. She's actually really probably about 21 right now. She just doesn't know how to cook. If she knew how to cook and drive, she probably would be going right now. It would be crazy. But so that's 3. Y'all gonna get to see us, everybody together, running around, running wild. You're gonna see the real deal, real family. You know what I'm saying? Make sure y'all subscribe, like, and do all the stuff these YouTubers be talking about.
Subscribe, like, and comment.
Yeah, we out here now. You better subscribe to our little shit. It's going, it's gonna go up. Boom, you know what I'm saying? Like, subscribe, you know what I'm saying? Comment, do the thing. You stupid, okay.